Hello everyone, welcome back to another stream. It's been a minute. Past 2 days where I live, there's been a pretty bad heat wave. And the room I stream in was really hot. So hot. I didn't stream because of the heat. Good news, the heat wave has passed. All is well in the world, at least in regards to my stream. And now we're back with some LA Noir. So, yeah. Hope we're all doing well. Let's jump back into it. Got to go to that,
You know the way. You can drive.
Ramez removals. The next part of this case. Hope we're all having a lovely... What day is today? Friday? Today's Friday? What? I thought it was Thursday. Alright, that's good news. It's Friday. We're all having a lovely Friday. They are selling it on the streets. Evening.
Looks that way.
But the mob wants returned customers, not corpses. Why haven't they cut the morphine?
Good question, detective.
This robbery happened months ago, right?
The beginning of the year.
So why are the proceeds suddenly turning up now?
Another good question. But where does it get us? It's like asking questions in the middle of the movie. If you just sit tight and keep your yap shut, you'll find out what happens. We need to follow the evidence.
LAPD. We're here to see Jose Ramez.
What's it about?
Routine inquiries, sir. Can you tell us where we can find him?
You missed him.
He was in the delivery.
Oh, shit.
Just went out.
God damn it. 11K calling KGPL.
Go ahead, 11K.
11K requesting assistance. In pursuit of narcotic suspects aboard a GM delivery truck. Commercial license David Charles 457.
This doing.
We're not playing around here. Take this clown off the road.
I did pretty good there for taking, in terms of taking him out for a second.
I can't hit a target that isn't there, Phelps. Hit him. Clear this asshole off the road.
Shit, they got him.
Keep your foot down.
Yo, what's up, Triple X? Welcome to the stream. Thank you for tuning in. How you doing today?
Get alongside him and take him out. Getting close. Steer him off the tar. That's it, Cole. You did it. It's truck's history.
Got him.
Hands behind your head. Jose Ramez, you're being arrested on suspicion of supplying illegal drugs, resisting arrest, and for malicious damage to LAPD property.
Hey, hold your horses. I supply furniture, not drugs. And that thing back there? That was an accident. Some furniture came loose. That's all.
Save it for the DA, Chico.
Keep an eye on him. We're gonna take a look around inside.
Pretty tired after the stream. I might play some COD if I feel like playing, but if not, I'll play Roblox. Nice, nice. What do you like playing on Roblox? Otherwise, I'm doing good. How about you? Well, I'm glad you're doing good. I'm doing okay. Heat wave's over. Back to streaming, thankfully. Busy. I'm currently busy packing stuff up for the apartment move. Also, some personal stuff came up in the past few days that's taking a big toll on me. But I'm working through it one step at a time, so we're working through it, and overall I'm doing all right. Could be worse.
Been delivering. And who's been delivering here? Any repeat business in the ledger, Cole?
Why is Ramez buying so much ice?
Brookhaven? What's Brookhaven? Is that a game on Roblox or just a different game in and of itself?
Melanati is buying a lot of furniture.
It's a roleplay game on Roblox. Gotcha. Is it fun? You like playing it?
Couldn't you think anywhere else to meet, kid?
We like to choose our ground.
What is that supposed to mean?
Huh? It's something Wellington said at Waterloo.
The I kind of like to play too much simp.
Fight. We're gonna fight, kid?
Gotcha. That reminds me of an idea that Bowboy had the other day when I was streaming.
You and your friend,
he pitched the idea that once a week you guys can pick a game for me to play on stream.
Fight,
once a week. What do you think of that idea? You think it's a good idea?
Some kind of stake?
It means my men are in cover, but that they can still shoot you. If those were my orders, you would all be dead now.
Are you kidding me? This is a $200 coat. You got some balls.
Kelso.
I hope you didn't scratch the paint of my new Lincoln.
Mm-mm. These guys are getting out of the dope business, Mr. Cohen. You'll have no more problems from them. The morphine is going to disappear back into the sea.
Hang on. You're getting hasty. There's a lot of dough on offer here.
Thanks for the offer, Mr. Cohen, but we are going to have to politely decline. After today, the morphine is no more.
This isn't the way we normally do business.
I'm aware of that, Mr. Cohen.
Call me Mickey. Are you aware of the risk, huh?
I'm giving it to you straight, Mr. Cohen. There will be no more morphine. We made a mistake and would like to back out gracefully. If you come after us, we will be forced to come after you.
You've been polite up till now, so don't stop making threats.
I don't make threats, Mr. Cohen. I'd like to thank you for your time.
Is that guy your idea, Muscle Kid?
There's something you should know about Jack, Mr. Cohen. He killed 6 Japs hand-to-hand with just a bayonet and a K-bar knife. His outfit, the 6 Marines, killed over 100,000 Japs in 3 months in Okinawa, and he was in the thick of it.
Those Japs are little guys, right?
Yes, Mr. Cohen. About your size.
Damn! Peak comeback. What did Bowboy say? So when I last streamed, Bowboy pitched the idea that you guys can pick what game I play once a week on stream. What do you think of that idea?
What's with the puddle? Where's that trail of water coming from, Cole?
There must be a way through the back. Welcome to Furniture Village, where taste comes to die. What a pile of junk. My mother would be in heaven.
Yeah.
I bet this is the kind of crap you love, Cole. 20 years out of fashion. Smells of old people in here.
Seems fair, not seeing the stream game every day and picking a game once a week sounds like a good idea. Gotcha. If I ultimately choose to implement it, I'll let you guys know in the Discord. But yeah, I just wanted your feedback on that idea. And here's the thing, is if I do that, you can suggest Roblox. I can play Roblox on stream. Or whatever other game.
You need to get up onto the floor above.
You suggested playing Among Us. I do remember that. And I will, as we get more followers, as I get more followers and more people on the Discord, I'll definitely organize a game of Among Us we can like all play together when we have enough people. So until we have enough people, we'll have to do other games. But once we have enough people, we'll definitely do Among Us. Crane be any fucking slower? Holy shit.
Get down here. There's a cold room in the back.
You just join a lobby on private and you can switch it to public. But XXX, the whole point of playing Among Us with viewers is that you do with viewers. Like,
I think we know where the water's
coming from. I don't know. Hear me out. What's the fun of me joining a random public lobby and just playing the game? Like, wouldn't you rather do it with viewers? We can all play together on like and talk with each other as we play.
PD, leave it right there. Everyone out of the vehicle and put your hands up.
There's something in the ice.
He's making a run for it.
Would you have to make a Discord talk? Yeah, I could do that. We can, on the Discord server, I can make a voice channel and everything for it. I can definitely do that. Sure, where'd he go?
Goddamn cover.
Fuck. I thought I could quickly gun him down. I gotta try again. There we go. Did not hesitate. Pulled up. Do what I had to do.
Hollywood Station. Have the ME and tech services go over this place.
Where will you be?
Hunting polar bear.
So to speak, hunting polar bear.
Can you drive to this one?
All right, where to?
Hey,
Is Audi serious? Is the LAPD turning a blind eye to narcotics?
Keep your shirt on, Phelps. Drugs are prohibited. Doesn't mean people don't want to take them. Limiting supply doesn't mean that we have limited demand.
I understand that. I know that the average Joe needs to unwind a little and let his hair down at the end of the week. Morphine? Heroin?
It's important to demonize Hop, Phelps. Looks good in the papers. But when all is said and done, it's just another chemical like booze. A lot of people in high places think we're doing the city a favor by keeping the dope rolling into Central Avenue. Donnelly certainly believes we need to keep them anesthetized.
Better jobs and opportunities would go a lot further.
Will you listen to yourself?
Factory is closed. Has been for years. Not much call for ice anymore with all those newfangled refrigerators.
Save it for someone who wants to hear it. How many janitors carry a gat?
Shit!
That's one way of announcing we're here.
Give it up, Finkelstein. Your brother-in-law will get you a good lawyer.
My brother-in-law hates my guts. Come and get me if you want some daylight with a suit of yours.
Throw out the gun. Got him.
This one's got your name on it.
Open. He's around here somewhere.
What the hell is the matter? Can someone please just kill these assholes already?
You're covered, Phelps.
I think one more to go.
They're all dead, Finkelstein. Leave the weapon and put your hands up now.
Put my hands up? Sure. Then what? Cop to peddling the dope? Cut a deal? Ship me off to the queue? Soon as I get locked up, some old friend puts an ice pick above my ear? No thanks.
Only one other way out, shitheel.
So come here.
Let's have a look around. Now that we've finally got some peace and quiet. I think I've had enough ice for one day. Until the scotch I pour myself as soon as we get out of here. This stuff has got to be worth at least $100,000.
So Finkelstein robbed the ship?
My guess is Lenny took it off their hands. This is big. This is gonna make the papers, Phelps. As senior investigator, I'll do the talking.
Well, well, who would have
thought that Roy Earl's handpicked new partner would have turned out to be such a great case man. This is a good result, Phelps. As far as we can tell, Lenny the Fink was moving the morphine across the city and as far north as Frisco. This makes the feds very happy, and it makes Mickey Cohen look bad. I won't lie to you, kid. I like the headlines. I like them a lot. You keep this squad in the papers, and we'll get along just fine. You know a Freddie Calhoun?
Sure, I know
Freddie. Freddie needs money to get out of town. Says he's prepared to blow the whistle on a Primo reefer distribution ring. Says he
can... Has he said how much it's gonna cost?
$50.
And the department will front me the 50?
You can put in an expense claim. He's over at Mike Lyman's on Hollywood Boulevard. See what you can find out.
$50? Do they think I'm made of money?
No, you just look like you're made of money.
Oh, very good. The kid's on form. I'd say on a scale of dull.
Yo, what's up, Bo Boy? Thank you for tuning in. Welcome to the stream. How you doing? Am I hot? Not anymore. The heat wave has ended. All is good in the world of my stream. We are back. Thank you for asking. How you doing, Bo Boy?
So you're the first. Born without a
You can drive.
What? Rochester, let me see that report. You see?
I'm doing all right. My shoes came in, so I'm happy. Are those the shoes that you told me about the other day on stream?
There's a little sneak. That's him in the back, Cole.
So, you gonna see your married man again?
Freddy, you're looking good.
You're gonna help me, right?
That's what I'm here for.
You got the money?
The 20? Sure, right here.
20? I said...
You want the money or the alternative?
Tell us about the reefer, Freddy.
Who's he?
Another good Samaritan. Answer the question.
Brass comes from Tijuana.
Glad to hear the shoes came out well.
They bring in 50 pounds a week.
50 pounds? Are you hallucinating, Freddy?
Get stashed at a house at 1452 North Las Palmas.
Names, Freddy.
The guy at the house is a spick that goes by the name Juan Garcia Cruz. Be careful. He likes guns. Or do I get my money?
Do me a favor, Freddy. Spend the money on a bus ticket. You can't last forever on a snitch jacket. Let's go visit this Cruz character. 50 pounds of dope. Crazy.
I can't decide between the tuna fish.
Drink
and
it like lemonade.
You're behind the wheel.
Do we know where we're going?
Oh, Bo Boy, I told Triple X about that. You guys vote on a game I play once a week idea, and he liked it. So we might just be doing that next month.
A hophead like Freddy would raffle his sister for his next score.
We'll be back in a bit. Take your time. No rush. But you might miss this really fun section of the game where I get to do a huge shootout. Got him.
I'll ask you politely to move on. Next time I won't be so nice.
Sad music.
You guys don't have to leave a mess. What happened?
Dope peddler, Juan Cruz. He opened fire and, you know, the rest of the story tells itself. Juan Garcia Cruz. This is his address, but this place looks like a front. Is this a drug or a village in Borneo? Doesn't appear to be in Spanish.
Doesn't anyone eat regular meals anymore? Junkies feeding on popcorn and grasshoppers living on soup.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address on a Parnell soup company. A head office or factory in the Los Angeles area.
Just a second, Detective. Only one address listed. 6310 Fountain Avenue.
Thanks, ma'am.
usually the guys keeping one so well stocked with soup.
Where's the other body?
Things out of circulation.
It's a random stock image of screws in there. It's really noticeable. It's not terribly placed, it's just noticeable, you know?
Like a girl.
Oop.
Now we're getting somewhere.
More soup? Who in the hell keeps a secret stash of soup?
You hungry or something, Phelps?
I'd say that's pretty good value for 12 cents.
Factory sealed. Someone at the cannery has a lot of explaining to do.
With Juan dead, we need a new suspect, Cole. Is there a pattern to the deliveries?
This guy EJ seems to be bringing in most of the serious weight. Dates and times seem pretty regular. We should notify the border crossing.
Those fuckers are probably in on it. Let's wait and see how this plays out.
I love this music. It's so good. Go to Parnell's Soup.
You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
Fine. Where are we headed?
Crothers says the morphine is still turning up.
Makes sense. We have no idea how much of the stuff Lenny shifted. There's been no comeback from Cohen as yet.
The Confidential magazine is right, and Bugsy is on the slide.
You read that stuff? I wouldn't say it to his face if I was you. That is one hot-tempered son of a bitch.
right. Let's see if we can find out who's been over-seasoning the soup in this place. LAPD. Who owns this factory, ma'am?
Mr. Parnell. Howard Parnell. I'll let him know you're here. Please, take a seat.
If you don't mind, we'll come with you.
If you must.
You just wanted a follower, yeah. Didn't you? You sly dog. I must apologize for my partner's roving eye. He hates saying goodbye, but he loves watching them leave.
Give it a rest, Roy.
If you could show these men in to see Mr. Parnell, Doris. They're from the LAPD.
Follow me, gentlemen.
One lady have not done that herself.
What is going on?
LAPD. Sit tight, fatso. You could be in very serious trouble.
There's no reason to be rude. Take a seat, gentlemen. I'm sure we can sort this all out.
Maybe you can explain why we found $5 bags of marijuana in sealed Parnell soup cans.
That's an outrageous allegation.
How do you explain it, Chubby? We found at least 30 cans, all sealed up tight with your label on them.
Can I get a list of your employees?
Of course. We have nothing to hide. Doris, can you bring me in the current employee listing?
Here it is, Mr. Parnell.
On the desk, please.
Kind of riz him up.
Any name on that list that rings a bell?
This is familiar. 1452 North Las Palmas. A Jorge Garcia Cruz. The factory sealed cans we found suggest a very professional operation, Mr. Parnell. We're looking for an inside man.
I know nothing about this. I want this stopped as much as you do.
Tell me what I want to know, Parnell, or I will have half the LAPD down here tearing this place apart. You're hiding something.
Am I right in thinking you would not want to pursue misdemeanors outside your drug case?
Depending on what you call a misdemeanor, we might be prepared to turn a blind eye.
The truth is, I employ a lot of illegals. No one wants to do menial work anymore. Most of my factory staff are wetbacks. The local blacks and Chicanos all want jobs in aircraft factories.
Presumably because the pay is a lot better. How are your sales, Mr. Parnell?
Just fine and dandy, son. We're entering a new era of prosperity. I hope you're both big soup eaters.
Doubt.
Mr. Parnell, do you know what kind of trouble you're in? Come clean with us.
Okay, so things are a little flat. We're deciding whether to lower production. It's taken a while to adjust to not having any military contracts. You know, we sold Uncle Sam 5 million cans of minestrone.
Ever heard of Juan Garcia Cruz?
Not that I know of.
He has a brother employed here. You know him?
We employ large numbers of Mexicans. I'm not familiar with them all.
That's funny, Parnell. He has the same address as his brother Juan, who we shot dead less than an hour ago. You better give me something.
Look, I'm not involved in this. I'm getting enough grief from Washington. There's an investigation going on into profiteering. Like a guy shouldn't be able to turn a buck while the war is on.
I'm sure thousands of dead Marines sleep soundly knowing that you did okay. Tell us about Jorge Garcia Cruz.
Jorge? I had no idea of his last name. His team does daily maintenance on the conveyor belts and cookers.
Ooh, good cop or bad? I'm gonna go good. Here we go.
He's here now?
No, maintenance is at night. Night shift finishes around midnight. He would usually come in around 9 p.m. and have everything ready for the morning shift at 6.
We'd like to take a look around the factory floor, Mr. Parnell.
I hope we won't have to shut down the line.
No, nothing like that.
Thank you. I'm grateful for that. I'll show you around myself.
I hate seeing how things are made. This is gonna be like that time I went to the slaughterhouse and couldn't eat steak for a week.
Produce comes in. We peel and sort all of the vegetables and add them to the line in regular quantities.
Fascinating.
Why don't you keep quiet? Might learn something.
Oh, good God. This really is turning into some nightmare school trip flashback.
This is the hopper, which boils and purees the vegetables. The other hopper is for the pasta. This way, please.
You're loving this, aren't you, Phelps?
The soup is ladled automatically into cans. Next stage is labeling.
I'd like to see the packing and dispatch area, if you don't mind.
Sure. It's over here. Follow me. This is one of our dispatchers. Sergio, right?
Yes, sir.
These men are from the LAPD. Sergio here records our outgoing deliveries. They all go in the book, just there on the desk.
We're looking for repeat business in large amounts, Cole.
What's going on, Parnell? There's enough soup going to this place every day to feed a company of Marines.
What are you talking about?
I'd like a private word with your dispatcher, if you don't mind.
Sure, go right ahead. I'll be over here when you need me.
Can I have a look at that coin?
Sure, why not?
Silver dollar, right?
Yeah, that's right.
The markings on it say it's been taken out of circulation.
Maybe. I'm not trying to buy anything with it. I like it. Brings me luck.
Do you have access to the canning area?
I do, but I keep to my station, loading and unloading. Don't care much for soup.
Sergio, if you don't give me something, I'm gonna go to Immigration Services and have you deported.
Oh, blunt.
Shipment once every 2 weeks. Ernesto does the driving. I don't know his full name. It's delivered here at night. Jorge gets it canned up. I'm here, it gets sent all over the country.
What do you know about the 20th century market?
Nada. I get the orders from upstairs. I send the goods where I'm told.
And you don't know Juan Garcia Cruz?
No, not me.
Sergio, you're in it, and I'm gonna break you for it.
You're loco, Placa. I got nothing to do with Juan Garcia.
We found a matching silver dollar on Juan Garcia.
Booyah.
What are the odds of that, Sergio?
Juan and Jorge are brothers. They're cousins. They work for some evil gabacho. The guy is an aberration. He gives out the silver dollars. Jorge gets me a list of deliveries every morning. 20th century is always out.
You keep your mouth shut for today, and I don't take you in. Do we have a deal?
Do I have a choice?
Is that a serious question? That's it for now, Sergio. If we need to speak to you again, we'll put in a call to Mr. Parnell.
If you have to, I guess.
We will be in touch, Mr. Parnell. It is imperative that things appear as normal here. Keep an eye on Sergio in case he gets tempted to blow the whistle.
Thanks. I'll do that. You're going to overlook my little immigration problem, aren't you?
Cheer up, Fatso. We're going to let you go on squeezing these poor saps a little while longer. Well, until some commie union types infiltrate this place. I am glad to be out of that place. I never knew fresh vegetables could smell so bad.
You can drive.
Do we know where we're going?
How many years have you been in Vice, Roy?
More years than I want to own up to, Phelps.
You have any idea who Rojas was talking about?
The gringo runs the operation? Could be anybody. You don't expect those morons to be running the show, do you? If you ask Rojas how much a silver dollar is worth, he'd probably say 50 cents. Sit tight. Let's take a look at what's going on.
Either these customers are serious soup lovers, or I think we found our middleman.
Car 11 King to KGPL.
Car 11 King, go ahead.
I'm requesting assistance in a B-Wagon at 20th Century Markets, 1558 North Highland. Numerous narcotic suspects. Code 2 only, no sirens.
11K, roger.
Okay. Cavalry should be here any minute.
Let's do this.
LAPD, nobody move!
I'll take my chances.
Whatever you're carrying, hand it over.
I'd say he's got about half a can left. I guess that makes me a pessimist.
You can't take me in.
True.
Take you in? Be glad he didn't shoot you. I wouldn't have chased you. If it was up to me, you'd be talking out of a hole in the back of your head.
I want information.
Senor, I would like to help you. But I got a family in Mexico I have to provide for. And my compadres are very unreasonable.
Your compadres? Turn out your pockets.
I need Ray to run down these silver dollars.
I need to make a deal. I need guarantees.
You have identification?
Sanchez Erto. Mexican, Tijuana address.
Here's the deal, Erto. You give me
information,
information
I will take immigration. That's one of the best lines in the game.
Give me EJ, the driver bringing in the shipments, or I'll make you for it.
I run the shop. That's all I do.
Start talking, Erto. I want the names of everyone involved.
Shit.
What difference does it make what I tell you? I'm still going to jail, no?
Tell me about the soup cans.
The soup is very popular, as you can see.
The real funny, wise guy. You want to try saying that again with no teeth?
I get a delivery at 7:30 every other day from the factory. Jorge organizes everything.
We know about Jorge and Juan. Juan is dead. Tell us how you know the Cruz boys.
Ernesto put together this thing. He brought in Juan, Juan brought in Jorge.
Continue.
I was already here. Ernesto knows I'm illegal, so he threatened to report me if I didn't help. And the money is good. The gringos and the gringas, they love the reefer. And I didn't want to have to leave and start again in San Francisco.
You're breaking my heart.
You're under arrest, Erto. I'll speak to the DA and see if he will agree to not seize your assets or deport you. That's the best I can do. You've got this one chance to cooperate, Erto. Give me your delivery boys, or you'll do every year that we were saving for them.
All right. There's a shipment coming in tonight to the soup factory. Parnell's soup factory, 1 a.m. Ernesto will be there.
We should get some backup and stake out the cannery tonight.
Freddie said they were moving 50 pounds a week. That's a lot of soup cans.
I think this is an interstate operation. Moving dope around the country to selected grasshoppers. Local weed gets distributed in the usual way, through Pachuco street punks.
Someone must know something about this drug baron character.
Here they come. Let him unload the goods first.
Now?
Let's get him.
Ah, shit.
All right, move. Move! Let's go!
Gotta get my gun! There we go.
Everyone into position.
Got your back.
LAPD, put your hands where we can see them.
Okay, gentlemen, we'll take the lead. You cover us. Go, get in there.
Weapons on the ground.
There we go.
I think that's the last of them, Cole.
Detectives, found something here you probably want to see.
The silver dollar. Again.
$1 per dead man. Doesn't seem like much for a human life. Tijuana address. We should see what the federales have on them.
I thought that would have been a clue. I guess it's really just a ticket for something unrelated. Don't see that often in this game. Where'd my hat go? It's over here, right?
God damn. I think we found our stash, Cole. Take a look in these boxes.
At the very minimum, another 50 pounds.
Detectives, I think we got the guy. Does the name Cruz mean something to you?
It certainly does.
I'll find my hat later, whatever.
$1,000 here. Yet another silver dollar.
Phelps, Earl, looks like quite a bloodbath. What was this all about?
Drugs and money. What else? Speaking of money, where did that roll go?
I picked it up for safekeeping. The department owes me 50.
Ray, I have another 2 coins for you.
Great. I've got something to show you. It's all set up on the table over here. There. Take a look at these coins you've been collecting.
There are letters cut into each coin, along with not legal tender.
Those are Morgan silver dollars from the 20s. They were removed from circulation and sent for disposal. A number of smelters around the country had the contract. Look at them together. Can you work out what it says?
First coin, M-A-S, the second, A-N-G, the third, K-A-Y, the fourth, M-E-T, the fifth, A-L-S, Masanke Metals.
A metal foundry. Would you like the address?
Would I ever.
1034 Vine Street, Hollywood. We'll finish up here.
You had that memorized, damn.
It's been a long night, Phelps. See if you can talk them into giving themselves up.
Any sign of my hat before I go? No? Shame. Guess we'll just no more hat for the rest of the case, sadly.
You know the way. You can drive.
Where are we going?
A better variety.
I hope that big wad of cash doesn't weigh you down.
Get your priorities straight, Phelps. We're close to bringing in one of the biggest dope cases of the year, and you're worrying about unsubstantial evidence? Locked. We need another way in.
Felt like it'd be this case, I was right. What I mean is I thought this case would be the one where we go into this building, and I was right. Because again, I have played this game before. Not my first run through. Headshot.
You okay?
I'll tell you when I see what's waiting for us at the top.
You're surrounded, and your buddies are dead.
Like that. I like that walking up animation if you still are zoomed. It's cute. The fucking Punisher, I don't give a shit. Chilling in here the whole time?
Victor Sanders. You know this guy?
I should have known.
Of course I know Roy. Roy and I have had an arrangement for many years.
You're under arrest.
Am I?
We have a mountain of prima facie evidence, as well as the testimony.
You'd be surprised how things have a habit of sorting themselves out. Evidence disappearing. Witnesses that can't be found. Policemen that forget. The impossible becomes probable when you have a client list like mine.
Shut your mouth! Turn around and put your hands behind your back.
Bro thought he was him. He was not.
Working vice can be a thankless task, Phelps. But on behalf of the brass and the moms and dads and the concerned citizens, I'd like to commend you and your partner for smashing this dope ring. Reefer is almost as big a threat to the children of this city as communism.
What about Sanders, Lieutenant?
Leave Sanders to me, Phelps. The chief will be looking after that one personally.
He will be brought to trial.
Phelps, we are celebrating your success. Don't push your luck. Sanders is no longer your problem.
Feels like Vice gives the player a first-hand perspective on corruption in the police department compared to the other desks.
Your platoon is what remains of recon. I'm folding you into the 22nd. You'll be going up that damned hill tonight.
We're intelligence gathering, sir.
I don't need intelligence, son. I need men who can hold rifles and kill Japs. Tonight, you're a rifle company. We've got cooks, mechanics, and stretcher bearers all going into the line. We aim to break them tonight, Lieutenant.
Good to see you, Hank.
You too, Cole. How's your war?
Not quite what I expected.
long as I live. I will never get over that sound.
Hey, who's that medic? He'll be killed going out there.
It's Sheldon, the guy from the Asakawa Bridge. That guy's got no fear.
He didn't make it.
I didn't go out there to save him.
What are you saying, man?
I went out there to put him out of his misery, to ease his pain. Do you have a problem with that?
Murder, Corman.
That's war, Lieutenant. Smell the stench. Feel the whore's breath on your neck.
You need help, man.
Call for me tonight, Lieutenant, when you're up on that hill. I've been up there 3 times already. The circles of hell have nothing on Sugarloaf Hill.
Get this madman out of my sight!
Phelps. I did a little boxing in the Marines. I found it a pretty humbling experience.
Fix you a sandwich, buddy. Corned beef and egg salad, 12 cents. Bologna and ham and cheese, 10.
It's strictly a mug's game. You'll like this fight, though. A plucky limey's about to take a beating from an up-and-coming Negro.
You sound pretty sure about the result.
I ought to be. I got 50 bucks on the black kid. Let's get a ringside seat. Son of a bitch Hammond made a run for his dressing room. Let's find out what's going on.
God damn you, Abbott! You get out here right now!
Step back! LAPD, what's going on?
That son of a bitch Hammond has jammed the door.
And who are you?
Carlo Arcaro. I'm his manager.
I'm his trainer.
Interesting attitude to have towards a victorious athlete.
Victorious? We had an arrangement. We had a goddamn arrangement! That limey bastard was paid to take a nap. He reneged.
And you were out of pocket?
Damn right. Me and a couple hundred other people.
Stand aside.
He squeezed out the window. I'll put an APB out on him.
Why would we do that? He won the fight fair and square.
To prevent him from getting clipped. He was paid to flop. There was big money riding on this.
So are we here because you lost money or because we're investigating a prize fighting racket?
Very funny. Look around and see what you can find. Which is Hammond's locker?
Over by the pinboard, second from the end.
There's a phone number we can run by R&I. Plus a bunch of names and odds. You're not the only one who likes a flutter, Roy.
You look troubled.
I'm in a jam, Doctor.
Can I help, Courtney? Is it money?
No, Doctor. That's okay. Do I have your professional confidence.
Whatever you say, we'll never leave this room.
I talked some of the guys in my old unit into doing something, and it's gone wrong. I guess I did it for the wrong reasons, for short-term gain. We came home from China on the Cool Ridge.
The morphine robbery.
That was us. I thought I could get the guys a fair share. Some sort of benefit for the sacrifices that they made in the war. Those guys deserve it, Doctor.
Oh, I'm sure they do, Courtney. But the deserving aren't always rewarded.
Tell me about it, Doc. Like, we shifted our stuff onto this mob-connected guy, and it's been turning up all over town. It wasn't meant to be like this.
The presumption was rather naive, Courtney.
I know that now, Doctor. But people are dying.
Might I venture a few questions?
Sure.
Do your underworld contacts have all the morphine?
No, they don't. We doled it out, hoping we could control it.
Are they pressing you for further allocation?
That's the polite way of putting it, Doctor.
I may be able to help you, Courtney.
Thanks, Doc. It helps just to talk about it.
I mean, I have a solution that will help you financially and salve your conscience.
I'm all ears, Doctor.
I will transact to take all the narcotic off your hands. And you can rest assured that it will all be medically administered. I will use the funds that I no longer require for the purchase of medication and invest them in housing developments.
Housing?
The developments in question are housing projects for former servicemen. Your return will come from the sale of the properties, and your investment will benefit those that you care for most. Does this arrangement meet with your approval?
You're a magician, Doctor.
What a goober.
You better find that cocksucker and you bring him to me.
I feel bad too, Mickey. He guaranteed me he would take the flop.
I guarantee that you will be fish food if you don't bring me... Roy, you out of pocket too?
Mickey, seems that way.
Don't worry about it. My boys are out looking for him.
Well, you'd better call them off. This is a police matter now. If anything happens to Hammond, I'll testify that you made threats against him.
Who's the Greyhound? He's a frisky one, isn't he?
Cole Phelps? Mickey Cohen.
I know who he is, Roy. I, met his brother-in-law.
Ah, shit.
I think you had the mixture pretty scared back there.
Operator, give me R&I. Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address for the following phone number. AL345.
The address for the phone number is... The Hotel El Mar, 6294 Leland Way, Hollywood.
Thanks.
You know the place? Flophouse. Quarter a night, no questions asked.
You're behind the wheel.
All right, where to?
You seem to have a pretty cozy relationship with Cohen and Stampinato.
Do I note a hint of reprimand in your tone, detective? Talking to gangsters comes with the turf. You should try out Mickey's place. He's got a haberdasher's up on Sunset.
Where'd you learn to drive?
See if he can get you out of those old man's clothes that you slink around in.
It's a front for his illegal activities.
It is that, but he does carry some very sharp suits.
If it's okay with you, I'll stick with Brooks Brothers.
Shout out to Brooks Brothers. Yeah.
LAPD. We're making inquiries into the whereabouts of an Albert Hammond.
No one here by that name.
You sure?
Sure, I'm sure. This isn't the sort of place where people use their real names. Take a look at the register if you don't believe me.
This guy's got a screw loose.
Okay, so look for prominent Tommies. That should narrow it down.
You're a real asshole. You know that?
Winston Churchill. A very patriotic Englishman is staying in room 207.
The old bulldog. Even at a flop house, Adley can't get out from his shadow.
This guy must have escaped from Looney.
Looks like he's had a broad up here.
Gives us angle if he has a real love interest.
You are a modest little person with much to be modest.
Looks like Albert's been doing some homework. $11,000 would be a nice little nest egg.
InstaHeat. Adrian Black's product of choice. Sounds like a lifetime ago.
That is a lifetime ago.
Candy has expensive taste. Albert has his work cut out for him.
Who's Candy?
Candy Edwards, the lady who filled out this coupon. I guess a fighter has plenty of time on his hands between bouts. Does Albert have somebody special? I didn't see anyone in his corner at the fight.
All right, let's go after his girl. See if that gets us any closer.
He must be heading home. You know, I hope he makes it.
That crooked son of a bitch, no chance.
Can you drive to this one?
Do we know where we're going?
So, you boxed in the Marines?
We all did. Standard training.
I can't imagine you ever played dirty.
The only prize for taking a fall was 1,000 push-ups.
Century Broadcasting Company salutes our...
We need to know which room is Candy's.
See him?
Can I help Sorry, you?
LAPD, ma'am.
He worked that
We're looking for Candy Edwards.
Apartment 7. You take the outside stairs by the parking lot and turn left at the top.
That looks like Margot Robbie.
You friends of the Italian guy.
Italian guy?
Yeah. Sleazy type. Gave his name as Carlo. I didn't like the look of him, but Candy has some funny friends.
Thanks.
This Candy broad must be as sweet as she sounds. All these gentlemen callers.
Give it up, bitch.
Sounds like we're missing He's all the fun.
Like hitting women, do you?
We had a-
This isn't gonna end well for you, friend.
Bro's about to hit the goddamn arrangement line again. Would have been funny. Considering how loud he screamed it, he was about to do it again. Complete a brawl without losing your hat. What a great achievement.
Out cold, but breathing. Give her a minute and take a look around.
Nasty weapon.
All the Italians carry them. A real man uses his fists or a gun.
Carlo here seems to have the same friends as Hammond. What are the odds on them all being bookmakers? She's leaving town. Single ticket, one way. I guess there isn't a lot for Albert in Ohio. Scania sails from New York. Take a seat, Miss Edwards. We have some questions for you to answer.
Look, I haven't done anything wrong.
Ever? I find that pretty hard to believe.
Can you answer some questions now, Miss Edwards?
Sure, I've had worse. I'll shake it off.
We're trying to track down Albert Hammond. We have reason to believe he might be in danger. Do you know where he is?
No, I don't. I'm over Albert. I haven't seen him.
You're lying, Candy. You were in his hotel room. He came back after the fight and you weren't there. What happened?
You can't prove that I was in the room.
And I will.
How do you think we found you, Candy? You wrote your name and address on a coupon.
Look, Albert was supposed to take a fall. We were all supposed to make a little money out of it. But Albert got too goddamn stubborn. Said his pride was all he had left. So I told him, shove it. Let's see his pride keep him warm at night.
So you walked out before the fight?
Yes, I did. What's the problem? I didn't take anything.
Do the names Harry, Mervin, or Ray mean anything to you?
Could be anybody. How the hell would I know?
Give up these men, Miss Edwards, and we'll think about letting these charges against you slide.
What? Charges against me? All I did was try and look out for Albert. Now he skips out and I have to take beatings for him as well?
You're leaving town, Miss Edwards?
Yes, I'm going straight home.
You're lying to me. Albert finally won a big fight. I say good luck to him. But you know where he is. Let me help him, Candy.
Do all you cops run off at the mouth? Prove I know where he is.
Don't ask, you never find out.
Albert is going home by boat as soon as he collects his winnings. I know you're going to meet him.
Albert is going to collect nothing. He'll be lucky if he can get out of town in one piece.
How will you fare any better? They already believe you're in on it.
Hell, I know you're in on it.
You can think what you want, Buster. I'll take my chances. I got a few errands to run, and then I say adios to this dump.
Do you want to press charges against Arcaro?
Just get him out of here. That's all I want.
Get out, Carlo, you hump. And get rid of that pig stick.
Good luck, Miss Edwards.
I hope things work out for you.
Thank you. It's very kind of you to say so.
Bad people are looking to hurt Candy, and yet she's not heading straight for the train station? I smell a payoff. I say stake her out. See where she goes. Tail this broad. Don't let her get away, but don't get spotted. I'll bring up the car behind you.
Supernatural. My first playthrough of this game, I remember this tracing being really hard for some reason. See if I have difficulty with it now. Too easy. Sprint.
When is America going to understand it's about giving, not getting?
Love this music. Team soundcheck is phenomenal. Love those moments I can just sprint, then hide immediately. This feels like a Looney Tunes thing I'm doing where I'm just constantly sprinting like an idiot. Like, watch. Run, 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 run. Stop. And we're good. Where's she going? All good. Watch, run, 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 run. Hide. Look like such a creep from an outside perspective, but I'm just a detective. Nailed it. Let's go.
Woman just came in here. She went out the back way. Said she was being watched.
How much did
she
collect?
$3,600.
How could she tell? She
claimed me out. On the Hammond Kid Galahad fight? You got it. I'm not complaining. We all made a lot of money on that one. Huge plunge on Galahad, and then Hammond knocks the bum out.
So she collected the money and went out through the back door?
Nope. She made a phone call over there, wrote something on a notepad, and then left.
What are you doing? An old intelligence trick from the Marines. We know where she's headed. Let's get moving. You're behind the wheel.
Fine. Where are we headed?
About to say, don't close the door on us.
Hammond backed himself to win.
And Candy is picking up the winnings. Smart play.
The question is Candy collecting on Albert's behalf, or is she cheating him too?
Car 11K, 11 King. Further to your request, Bunko Fraud has 3 known bookmakers operating out of storefronts in the Hollywood area. Thrifty Liquor, 6106 Santa Monica, the Examiner Drugstore, and a Max Spirits at 1658 North Cherokee. KGPL clear.
She wants a 5-star goddamn wedding.
Detectives Phelps and Earl, LAPD.
Relax, Cole. You just have a blonde in here, Mervin?
Sure did. I'm just about to close up. She took me to the cleaners. 4,000 clams and change.
How long ago did she leave?
Maybe 5 minutes. Called a cab. Asked for a number. I told her there was a card over there by the phone.
Where's the phone? There it is.
Yellow cab. We need to get after her, fast. Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Can you connect me to the Yellow Cab Company? Hollywood 2187, please. This is Detective Phelps, LAPD. You dispatched a cab to 1487 Ivar Avenue, Hollywood.
Yes, sir. Send one round from the pool.
Do you have the number of that cab?
Number 179.
Thanks.
We're done playing around. Get Mervin to give us an address on Ray's place.
Run like a mad dog.
You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
Where are we going? We're here now.
Wrong place.
You can drive.
This broad's planning on cleaning out every bookmaker in town.
Hammond needed to make sure he was getting a bigger payday than if he'd taken the flop.
Never trust the Limeys, especially where a fight's concerned. A mistake we can't seem to stop making.
Be inside.
We're on the move again, Cole. After her. Don't lose that cab. Hammond is over the hill. He's a punching bag for the up-and-comers. She knows goddamn place.
I think he knows. I think he worked out the place isn't L.A.
He's punchy. His brain's going to mush. Winston Churchill? Give me a break.
Churchill is a fighter, Roy. Hammond didn't just scribble down the first name he could think of.
Hammond is full of himself, being this sure he was gonna win. That bitch has given me what I'm owed. That's all I know.
I feel like in real life it'd be more than obvious we were tailing them, you know? Ooh, but then again, what do I know?
She's heading inside.
I think I just saw Hammond. I'll tail him. You get in there and stay with Candy. Make sure you don't let her see you.
A turkey salad sandwich was great.
I swear, this town's going straight to hell.
This guy's got a screw loose.
Oh, shit, this is a scary part of the game.
Look, that's the latest thing.
Aw, oh, shit.
Rourke! Call an ambulance.
Hammond got away.
Try and sit still, Candy. Who shot you? Was it Albert?
Car.
They're on the way. I have a patrolman searching the depot. The chief's putting together a manhunt for Hammond. He got the money, right?
Looks like it.
A tough bird, our limey friend. Using his girlfriend as the bag woman and then getting greedy over the split? He won't make it out of town.
That's how you see it?
I told you that cocksucker was a crook.
Damn.
.32 caliber. One shot fired. Egyptian theater.
So, what now?
The theater, I guess. We don't have much else to go on. You know the way. You can drive.
Fine. Where are we headed?
Poor girl. She didn't deserve that.
Poor girl. Half the precinct aren't taking a vacation this year because of her. You need to leave town a lot quicker than that if you decide to screw over Mickey C.
This seems like a long shot. Aren't they all?
Car 11 King, come in.
Car 11 King.
Message from the coroner. The cause of death was a knife wound. Repeat, a knife wound. Revolver appears to have belonged to the victim.
KGB. Son of a bitch. He stabbed her.
I thought you said real men use their fists, not guns.
That guinea cocksucker. You think he got the money too?
Come on, Roy. We're bringing this whole tragedy to its conclusion.
Why'd you kill her, Carlos? Your gripe was with me. She was collecting the money for you. Mickey made it clear, it's either me or you. And she stole those betting slips. She was running out on me.
And you were gonna let her?
No, I let her collect. I set her up, just like she set me up. Just like my manager set me up. Everyone wanted me to take the dive. Everyone wanted me to take the short money. It's for the best, kid.
You were washed up, kid! You couldn't climb, and you were too brave to sink. You were going nowhere!
Maybe, but I had heart. I was a Royal Marine, Carlo. If I lost a fight, it wasn't for lack of trying. And it wasn't for lack of courage. I didn't have much. But I had that.
I did it for you, and that's how you repay me!
You did it for yourself. So did little boy. You did it to make the quick buck. And Candy did it to make your dream come true.
Blah, blah, blah. I've got the money. All I need to do is get rid of you. It's gonna be a shame, kid, but that's business.
We've heard enough, Arcaro. Put down your weapon.
You're making a big mistake.
I'm covered. I'm wide open.
What's up, Bubba? Welcome
it's
back.
To come out now, Hammond. Put the gun down, Roy. That son of a bitch owes me a lot of money. Catch. Yaskanya sails from New York, Hammond. Be on the next train and don't ever come back.
Why?
Because I was a Marine and I once lacked courage. Everyone deserves a second chance. Now beat it. Fuck you! That English prick is getting away with my money, Phelps!
Donnelly and the Homicide Squad send their best, Phelps. They're more than pleased that you wrapped up the Edwards killing. They're a little mystified about the motive. You have any ideas on that?
Crime of passion, sir. Looks like some sort of love triangle between the manager, the fighter, and the... his girlfriend.
No sign of the scrapper?
No, sir. Looks like he left town after the fight.
Okay. It's homicide's problem now. Good work, gentlemen.
It's one of the best cases in the game, to be honest. Super climactic and everything.
187 at 5810 Murata Avenue. Homicide wants you over there. The coroner thinks the broad was whacked using the army morphine. Don't say anything, Roy. Just get over there.
Yeah.
That bum took a swipe at me and put him down on my staff.
What's with that getup of yours anyway? I should start introducing us as Detective Earl, and this is my science teacher, Mr. Phelps.
Your interest in my appearance is starting to get me worrying.
Like it or not, we're a dysfunctional couple now. People judge me with you on my arm same way they would a fat broad with a 5 o'clock shadow.
I really hope you're joking, Roy.
Really hope you're joking, Roy.
I
Really hope so.
You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
You seem distracted. We recovered the morphine. Some of it might be unaccounted for, so what? That's life. We did our job.
Closing one case opens another.
Do you have any idea what is really going on while we're wasting our time following this stuff?
Are you going to tell me?
The deals being done right now will change the face of LA forever, and we're wasting our time on some hump.
Someone's little girl.
Visit the morgue at the end of the month when the John and Jane Doe's are cremated. Their percentages, the odds for and against lightning striking.
I joined. Sorry, I joined so late. I was gonna join like 20 minutes ago, but I lost time studying German. Schoolwork comes first, my guy. It's all good. Appreciate you tuning in at all. I hope studying German went well.
Bukowski, you made homicide.
That I did. Good to see you, Phelps.
You two want a hug? Or can we get on with this?
Relax, Rusty. 26 years old, fashion model. Found in the tub by the cleaning lady, Mrs. Reynoldson. She called it in.
In schoolwork, was it just for fun?
Others likes to make work for people. Overdose of sleeping pills. Falls asleep in the tub. Rest in peace. Case closed.
Hear, hear. Mal is 100% that it's murder.
Do you mind if I take a look around?
Sure. Go right ahead.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to be ending the stream here. You've been learning German for 10 months. Nice. I hope it's been going well. I hope you're fluent soon. Anyway, going to be ending the stream here. Thanks, everyone, for watching. Tune in tomorrow night at 9 p.m. CST for some more LA Noir. If that changes, I will announce it on the Discord and Twitter. But if not, see you guys tomorrow. Peace.
for an airtight
beat. Silence of the Lambs type beat, for real.
You heard him, Cole. He's fucking nuts. What are the chances of hauling him out of here alive?
Basis for all his riddles. Prometheus defied the cruel gods. This guy thinks he's doing the same thing.
Defying gods can be hazardous to your health. Going down there?
You're an interesting man, detective. Why the police? Do I get a sense you're looking for? Reinforcements are on the way. Cease and desist.
Bro took a lot of shots. We got him.
Where's the press, Cap? I think Phelps and I should get a medal for this. This has got to be the case of the year, right? The case of the century, when you think about it.
Are you finished?
Yes, Skipper.
Good. Because there won't be any press briefings or commendations.
What are you talking about? We got the werewolf, the guy who killed the Dahlia, killed all the other broads.
You got no one. Mason was a ghost.
Can you at least tell us why, Captain?
Mason is the half-brother of one of the most highly elected officials in this country.
How high?
Beyond the moon.